All right, I found a mushroom that is kind of hard to find sometime, but it's an excellent beginner's mushroom because it's so easy to identify, and it's the old man of the woods. And literally, I'm sure some people have seen these just driving down the road in other people's yards, because that's pretty much how I found this one. I have permission to be in this person's yard. So right here's the yard, and right here is the mushroom. Now, if we're driving down the road, you can sort of spot that if you have a good eye looking for mushrooms. But notice that it has this black scaly cap on the top. It's very fringy on the edges, and you can see that it's very gray to black and kind of scaly looking on the top. That's the cap. There's the size of my hand. So you can see, you know, grabbing that, it's almost about the big around as a baseball right now. And so they can get rather big. Now, here's one right here that has been chopped up, and you can see that the flesh is black. But we're going to look at this here in a little bit, because the flesh of these is actually white, and they will turn reddish colored then black after a little bit. Some things we want to notice: that the old man of the woods is a bolete. It's got a big thick and heavy stalk. These are edible, and the stalk is extremely tough and hard. So we're going to just pick this real quick. We're going to break it off right there, and we're going to look at the bottom. And boletes have these little pores on the bottom underneath. They do not have gills. So that's what distinguishes boletes from other mushrooms. And you usually find the boletes later in the summer, going into fall. Today, it's just about the end of July, and that's a good time to start finding boletes. Now, the flesh and the spores will bruise. So, like, if you were to put your finger down and kind of move that across, you'll start to see over time that getting black. And it'll start getting darker and darker and darker. So there's a good, easy way to tell old man of the woods from other mushrooms. Like I said, this is an extremely easy mushroom to identify. Again here, I just found another one. I found the top of this one. There's one that's smaller. Here's the one that we just picked. And there's one that's coming up. And you can see how hard it can be to find these, because they blend in so well with their surroundings. Now, we're by a hemlock tree, and there's some hemlock and there's a walnut tree here. But usually you want to find these mixed hardwoods, and sometimes you can find them in conifers, and you want to look on the ground. There's not that you have to look in people's yards to find them. You can find them, most people find them in the middle of the woods, but this just has a little bit of decaying matter with some leaves and some branches that are right here, and just has perfect conditions for these to grow. These are an edible mushroom, but most people, they only pick them because they're edible, not because they're anything spectacular. So if you see one, throw it in your basket and you can cook it up. Nobody really raves about them, but most people, if they see them and they're out hunting for edible mushrooms, they pick them up and throw them in their basket anyways. But let's check and watch and see if the flesh of this mushroom turns colors. Let's break this open here real quick. So there we can see the white. We can see the white, and look how quickly it's starting to turn a pinkish color, pinkish orangish, orange rusty color. That will keep turning color until it turns black. That'll be black, and they'll kind of look black when you cook them up too. So let's take this one here. Now, I'm not going to cook any of these up, but I just want to show you for video purposes, you know, what it looks like. So we're going to break that, and let's watch those turn color. You can see that starting to turn color right now. I mean, instantly turning that shade, and you can see where my finger pushed really hard into that flesh. That blackened really quick, but you can see how it's slowly starting to turn red, and that'll keep getting darker and darker and darker. Let's do this again. Break off this side, and you can tell that it does not take very long. If you take your finger and just scar it, you can see how it goes a lot quicker where it's scarred, but it's just so interesting how quickly that turns color. So there's a very, very easy way to identify. Look at that color now compared to what it was just literally a minute ago. So this mushroom is edible. Now you would want to take the stalk off when you go to eat this mushroom. You would cut it off right here and you would just eat the cap. And you want to eat the very, very young ones. This one here, the top is, it's not, you feel if they're mushy. If they're really mushy, it's going to be not very tasty. But as you can see, it stains really black on the bottom where the pores are. The flesh goes from white to a reddish, rusty color. Then it will begin to turn black. You cook these up, they'll be black. And you usually don't find a whole lot. They're kind of scattered around. It's not like you'll find one, you'll find a big giant flush of them. But this year we had a lot of rain. There was two or three over there about 20 feet away, and there's two here. And that's usually about all the more I ever find in one spot. But again, it's a very easy mushroom to identify. Old man of the woods. It's an edible. It's a bolete. Start looking at the end of July into August. So if you really like this video, subscribe, like, share the video with your friends, and leave a comment below, because the more I find out from the viewers that this is the type of stuff they want to see, I'll make more videos. So hope you guys enjoyed this one. Till next time.